executive director of the Connector, and I will say it has been my pleasure and honor to work with somebody, one of the hardest working people I've ever met. She is absolutely committed to coverage. She is absolutely committed to equity and justice around healthcare. And she couldn't have been a better partner for us as a part of this process getting to open enrollment. So with that, Jean.
Thank you so much, Secretary. That's such nice words. Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor, as well. So some of you probably have met me because I was here exactly a year ago. Very excited to welcome the Affordable Care Act to Massachusetts. We were doing a lot of groundwork along with our colleagues here in other parts of the state. So things didn't turn out exactly the way we had anticipated, as you all know, that we had a very, very challenging IT launch the last go-round. And I just wanted to take a moment to acknowledge that we are deeply sensitive to a lot of problems that people have gone through, the confusion and the frustration, no one is more frustrated than we were, and so we just wanted to take a moment to say we're sorry for some of the things that happened to, you know, folks in your neighborhood and, you know, the things, the people that we're trying so hard to serve and bring healthcare to. That being said, I think if you take a look at what we have been doing for the past 6 to 8 months, there were some hard lessons learned, and we're really taking those lessons learned to heart and incorporate them in the implementation efforts that we have since launched. I'm very confident, and I'm sure Secretary as well, that we're going to make it work this time around, we're not going to disappoint you. So that's just something I wanted to highlight. Now, in addition to progress that we're making on the IT front, I think it's very important, just like the Secretary highlighted, to point out that we're just so proud of the work that this community has done to really bring more people to coverage, notwithstanding all the problems that we have had on the IT front. The Commonwealth actually has more people under coverage now than a year ago, thanks to a lot of the creative things that our colleagues around the state work tirelessly to achieve. So we're excited that we're going to have a new opportunity to move more people into quality healthcare coverage. Just like the Secretary mentioned, there will be people good prevention care, good access to primary care, and good services when people need medical care. So it's a great opportunity. I would just take a moment to tell you a little bit of specifics about what is going to happen in the fall. I think this is something that we all are looking forward to understand so that we're all on the same page as we get to work. So the first thing I would say is just that there is, as the Secretary alluded to, there is a open enrollment, it's a national open enrollment period that is going to start on November 15th. November 15th is the start of the federal open enrollment period, and this period will end on February 15th. So we're talking about a 90-day period open enrollment. This is where anybody can come in and select a plan or change a plan for any reason. Come November 15th, people can come in and apply for coverage that is going to be effective January 1st, 2015. So in other words, new coverage that starts January 1st, 2015 will be available for purchase starting November 15th. What that means is that people will be able to come in, log on to our website, submit an application, or call our call center, or submit a paper application, or walk into our walk-in center to submit an application. So all of these channels will be open come November 15th for coverage that starts January 1st, 2015. So that's kind of what we mean by, you know, things get started. Now, in terms of helping people get through that process, we have sort of some additional details to talk through. As you probably know, that our highest priority in terms of getting what we need to achieve for open enrollment is to transition a lot of people from either legacy coverage or temporary coverage to ACA compliant permanent coverage. So we're actually going to be reaching out to to about 400,000 people in the state. Many of them, I believe, live in this neighborhood. So people, you know, you probably know a lot of them. So up to 400,000 people across the state, these people need to be moved into new coverage. And let me talk about them sort of one by one. It's largely three cohorts. The first is Commonwealth Care. So many of you are probably familiar with Commonwealth Care. It was the Massachusetts subsidized insurance program previously administered under the Massachusetts reform law by the Health Connector. So this program has been extended through this year so that people can continue to access Commonwealth Care coverage when we were having IT problems. Again, many of those members, I think you know their names. So we have about 85,000, so you know, in that close to 100,000, has been some ups and downs, many people. So their coverage is going to actually end. It's not gonna end December 31st because we have worked, the secretary has led the team working with the federal government to give us an extra 30 days. So this coverage will end January 31st, 2015. So in other words, after this date, Commonwealth Care will go away. So what that means is that people have between November 15th and whatever the deadline is to get them through January 31st to make that transition. So you have a little more than 60 days. Now, you are able to get access as soon as January 1st, 2015, but it's just in terms of the period that you have to work with before your coverage is gonna go away, it's a little over 60 days. It's still an incredibly short period of time, so people need to pay attention. So that's the first program. The second program that is also subject to this transition is the temporary Medicare coverage. So many of our neighbors and friends and people that we know received notices from MassHealth throughout this past year telling them they have access to temporary Medicaid coverage until their permanent eligibility is determined. So this is the temporary program. We have close to 300,000 people in this program right now, and all of them need to submit a new application through the system and in transition to their new coverage depending on the outcome of the eligibility. So we are going to put these 300,000 people into three batches, and then it's with different end dates of their coverage, which is January 15th, February 1st, and February 15th. Again, we have more details on this in many, many places, but I just wanted to tell you at the high level, these 300,000 people will be in three different batches, and they have different coverage end dates during the course of basically the end of middle of January and middle of February. So this is, you know, what we need to do to make sure that these people take the right action within the time frame, and then so they can move on to new coverage without gaps. There is a third cohort of people. These are people who are actually covered by the Health Connector via their qualified health plan program. These people do not receive any subsidies. There are about 35,000 of these people, and then they also need to submit a new application through the website, and so they can get to new commercial coverage. So the three programs are Commonwealth Care, temporary Medicare program, a Medicaid program, temporary Medicaid program, and commercial qualified health plan program. Again, if you have questions, please ask me or many others who have been trained. But the important thing is there will be a lot of communication that goes out to you in the next several weeks. We'll phase it in the next several weeks. So mailing is starting to go out in October, and then they will specify what category a member falls under so they can take the right action. Now, I am sure it sounds a little bit confusing, if not very confusing, so I just wanted to highlight that we are going to do a lot of work to provide education and help, and we make sure that our people who are knowledgeable about the details available in the right place so that people can get help when and where they need it. So that includes, obviously, the mailing that we're going to send out. We're going to have an outbound call campaign so people will be receiving receiving calls, telling them that you are identified as one of this, part of this program, and here are the actions that you need to take, and please do X, Y, and Z. So we're going to do that. We're also going to have a door knocking campaign. So we're working with Healthcare for All to knock on about 200,000 doors in the state during the open enrollment season. So you may want to spread the word that if people knock on your door, check it out. And obviously, we will also have advertising campaigns and et cetera. But I just wanted to make sure that we highlight the Navigator program along with our Certified Application Counselor program, which our provider organizations are an extremely important part of this outreach campaign. The Navigators, such as Greater Lawrence Community Action Council, are one of the 15 organizations that we have identified and certified across the state who are trained and will be collaborating with us closely, the Health Connector and Medicaid, to provide community-based outreach and education and also enrollment assistance. So these are the people who are actually able to sit with a member and fill out an application front to back. And these people will help you work with our call center and with our agencies directly as needed to make sure that all problems are resolved. Now the good news is our navigators, many of them, have already had a year working through, frankly, very, very challenging situations. So we are more confident than ever that these people are going to do a great job in the community helping members as they need. So I just wanted to take a moment certainly to thank you, thank Evelyn and team for being there with us this past year. And I wanted to make sure that our community understand that this is a great resource that they are able to access so we can get through this open enrollment period successfully. So I'm going to stop there.